Hey, Mama Llamas, how are you guys doing today? I hope you're doing well. So today we got another speed bill, but not just any speed bill. This is actually a Christmas tree farm. I love these types of builds. I love Christmas tree farms and like stuff like pumpkin patches and just seasonal community lots. Some of my favorite things to build and have in my game. I don't know, I just feel like it adds a lot of realism in your game, which you know I'm a big proponent, I think, of realism in The Sims 4. So yes, this is called Joey's Tree Farm. I can't really find any tree farms that I like on the gallery or even on other places like The Sims Resource or like when I go to like CC Finds Tumblrs and they have like the little lots page. Like I looked through those and I didn't really see anyone, any tree farm that I liked. So I was like, you know what? I'm just going to build one myself. So here I am building a little bit of a tree farm, and it's not just a tree farm. The actual lot is a cafe lot. So I did put like a little cafe, and then I have a bonfire and what else? Some horseshoe, like horseshoe game, whatever. I don't know what they're called, but like you can play horseshoes. I did put some like hot chocolate stands, like winter stands and like hot dog stands and stuff. So yeah, this lot pretty much has everything that your Sims will need for the holidays. But I just wanted to give you guys a quick disclaimer that this build will be tray files only for some reason. My gallery hasn't been working for a while. So don't sweat it though. You will be able to download the tray files and put this in your game. If you don't know how to install tray files, it's super easy. I'll go ahead and link a tutorial down for you below. But yeah, it's super easy. It's basically like the gallery, except you're just taking the actual files of the lot and putting them in your game. So what are we doing now? So yeah, I did make that big like enclosed area with the lights on it. That's going to be where all the trees will be. If you want to make this a retail lot and like actually sell some trees, go ahead and do so. I just wanted it to make a cafe because I wanted the actual cafe bar thing to work and actually have somebody hired there without you having to do it. But yeah, like I made a little farm. I thought it was super cute, and I did try and experiment with like the open door concept there, but I don't know, I didn't like it that much. And I was also like, what if it snows? Like if it snows, like all the snow is gonna get in the barn, you know what I'm saying? But I've been talking too much. If you don't know me, my name is Anomaly, but you could call me Ali for short. We are all friends here. I make primarily Sims 4 content on my channel. I've only been doing YouTube before like a month, but I'm literally having a blast. Like, I really don't care how many people watch my videos, how many subscribers I get. I'm just having so much fun. It's kind of always been my dream to have a Sims 4 channel. I've always been a storyteller. Even before I started my channel, like I would actually like tell out the stories of my Sims in my head. Like I would like talk to myself. It was kind of weird. Not really weird, but yeah, I love to storytell. Building's not really 100% my thing. I like to do it, but yeah, so I also wanted to do a little bit of self-promo, nothing too crazy, but if you don't know what Fiverr is, it's kind of like a freelance website where you can put like job listings out, not job listings, but like you can offer people your services as a freelancer, and there's a lot of things you can offer and you can buy. Like people can make your like YouTube photo. Like that's what I did for my photo right now. Oh, I love it, it's so cute. I had somebody make it for me on Fiverr. I paid them, but it's super worth it because it's really, really cute. But I just started college and college is really expensive, so I have a few gigs up on my Fiverr account. So one of them is I can create a sim for you, any kind of sim that you would want for only about $5. I know it sounds weird, like, you know, you could go on the website or you can go on the internet and get any sim you want, you know what I'm saying? But like if you wanted a truly personalized sim and you didn't feel like making it yourselves, I could totally do that for only $5. Now don't be don't feel like you need to do this. Don't feel pressured at all. Seriously, I don't want to make you guys feel like I need this. It's just a little bit of extra help for college, for college books and stuff like that. So if you want to, go ahead. You definitely don't have to, but the offer is there. I also have like a building gig if you want me to build like a specific thing for you, whether it be residential, community lot, whatever it is. And then I have a video editing gig. So if you're in need of like video editing, you just don't have the time or you don't really know how to do it, I do have a gig up there too where I can edit your videos. So go ahead and check that out. But again, don't feel pressured. This is not a necessity for me. It's just a little bit of side cash to pay for my college books and tuition and stuff like that. Well, I am going to community college, so it's not like I'm going to a big university where I need like thousands of dollars to be able to pay my tuition, but it does help out just a little bit. So right now I'm putting some dirt around the place and I will be putting a few trees and stuff. Because I was like, you know, we need more trees than just those little pine trees, Christmas trees. But I love the way the lights light up at night. It's so cute. And I think next I kind of want to build a pumpkin patch, but I'm not sure how I'm going to go about it without downloading like custom pumpkins. Because like the only other way I would have to do it is put like the actual carved pumpkins in the game. And I wanted like not carved pumpkins. I wanted just straight up pumpkins, no faces or anything to put in like the pumpkin patch. So I'm not sure what I'm going to do about that. We will see. But I'm going to go ahead and end my voice over here. Be on the lookout for another episode of Antonia's Legacy. I know that's not really a super popular thing on my channel, but I really love it. It's so much fun. I love Antonia. And I can't wait to see where her story goes. 100 Baby Challenge coming out soon. What else? Oh, I'm kind of thinking of doing a reshade tutorial because I did have somebody ask if I wanted to, or I had somebody ask if I could do a reshade tutorial, I believe, a few weeks ago. So I might do that because I know reshade can be kind of confusing, but I love it. Like I cannot not play without reshade. It just makes the game look so much brighter and better. Now I'm not too crazy on the reshade. I don't go like super vibrant with a lot of exposure. I like my game to be a little, like have a little bit of color, but nothing too insane. So I'll definitely consider doing a little bit of a reshade tutorial. But yes, guys, here I am. I think, I'm putting the lights up on the little, like, fence post thing. I had to, like, do the Control 9 thing. But that's a new thing I learned recently, and I love it a lot. But don't forget to leave a like on the video if you enjoyed this, and turn on your post notifications so you get notified whenever I post a new upload. And as always, don't forget to subscribe for more Sims 4 videos. Bye, y'all.